Welcome back everyone to the series on working with a React Data Grid of Syncfusion. Last time you saw how to handle the CRUD operations in Grid at the server side using Data Manager. In this video, I will create a custom service to communicate with the server using the Fetch API and then bind the custom service to the Data Grid using the client side event of Grid component. I will open my existing application which I created in my previous video using Data Manager. You can also get this example from the description part below, or you can listen to my previous video shown in the above card. In this sample, I already created a mock server using Express.js and bound the server endpoints using Data Manager. For this video, I will do some changes in the endpoints in such a way so that it follows the REST architecture. Change the endpoint orders to API/orders and the HTTP method from POST to GET. For inserting a record, I will change the endpoint to API/orders. For deleting a record, change the HTTP method to DELETE and the endpoint to API/orders/ID. For updating a record, change the HTTP method to PUT and the endpoint to API/orders/ID. The server is ready. I will start the server using the command node space src/server.js. Now the server is up and running in the port 8080. In my previous video, I bound the server APIs to the Data Grid using the Data Manager. But now, I will create a custom service and bind it to the server using Fetch API. Create a new file, orderService.ts, in the SRC folder. I will create four functions to get, add, update, and delete the records. The Express server is running in the port 8080. So create a constant to hold this base URL. Create a function getOrders. Using the Fetch API, call the endpoint API/orders. This endpoint will return all the order records, which I will return from this function. This is the function from where the grid fetches its initial data. Open the app component and import this function getOrders from order service. To load the data grid with initial data, first create the state data and bind it to the data source props of the grid component. Then call the getOrders function in the useEffect hook. This returns the record details which I will set to the state data. Now the grid is populated with the initial data. Now I will explain about the client-side data source changed event of the grid component. Whenever I perform CRUD operations on the data grid, the data source changed event will be triggered. So with the help of data source changed event, I am going to manually handle the CRUD actions of grid now. First, I will create a callback function data source changed. I will log the state in the console so that you can get an idea about the fields retrieved within this method. I will add a new record now. Look at the notable fields in the console like action, data, and request type. Here the action is add. Data field will have the details about the newly added record. The request type is save to indicate the action of saving a new record into the database. Now I will update a record. Look at the console. Now the action is edit. Data field holds the updated record details and the request type is save to indicate the action of saving the updated record. Now I will delete a record. Look at the console. Here the data holds the details of the deleted record, which is of type array because you can delete multiple records at a single update, which we will discuss in later videos. And the request type is delete. Using these details, we will make the required calls to the server. If the action is add, then call the insert API with the added data. If the action is edit, then call the update API with the updated data. If the request type is delete, then call the delete endpoint. Open the order service again. Add a function addOrder, which accepts the new order details in its parameter. Using the fetch API, call the endpoint api/orders with the post verb and the order details in the body. This endpoint will return the success code 200 on a successful addition. Return a success message from this function. Add a function updateOrder which accepts the modified order details as the parameter. Using the fetch API, call the endpoint api/orders, get the primary key using order.orderID and append it to the endpoint. Set the verb as put and add the updated order details in the body. This endpoint will return the success code 200 on successful update. Return the success message from this function. Finally, create a function deleteOrder which accepts the primary key as its parameter. Using the fetch API, call the delete endpoint api/orders with its primary key. This endpoint will return the success code 200 on successful deletion. Return the success message from this function. Now the custom service is ready to use. Next, I will bind the service with the dataSourceChanged event to the appropriate actions. Open the app component and import these service methods addOrder, updateOrder, and deleteOrder from the order service. In the dataSourceChanged callback function, call the addOrder function if the action is add and pass state.data as the argument. In the output, if I add a new record to the data grid, the new record is added. Open the network tab of the developer tool, you could see the post endpoint is called with the order data in the body and received the success response from the server. Call the function updateOrder if the action is update and pass state.data as the argument. In the output, if I update a new record in the data grid, the record is updated. In the network tab, you could see the put endpoint is called with the updated order data in the body and received the success response from the server. Call the function deleteOrder if the request type is delete and pass the primary key as the argument. As the data will be of type array, on delete action, get the order ID from the first element in the array. In the output, if I delete a record from the data grid, the record is removed. In the network tab, you could see the delete endpoint is called with the primary key in the body and received the success response from the server. Let me summarize some of the major points which we discussed in this video. First, we created the REST endpoints using the Express server. Then we saw about the dataSourceChanged event of the grid component. We then created the custom service for API calls using fetch API. Finally, we bind the custom service within the dataSourceChanged event for handling CRUD operations. Thanks for watching this video. If you find this video as helpful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.